happen to children being seen and not heard?
They're just having fun, George.
I can't think in all this chaos.
When she sensed a strange presence, she had sought out the intruder, but had only managed to capture his shadow. Since then, she has been on high alert.
What have you lost now, George? You're going to be late.
My cufflinks! I don't suppose they've been turned into two golden dolphins and swum off across the sea.
That's a very inventive idea, George.
Well, I think. Ah! Look at my trousers! They're covered in dog hair. I'm so hairy that people on the street will probably start calling me roving, throwing bones. Nana, come here, now! I'm surprised you're not completely bald, the amount of hair you've transferred to me. Liza, Liza, take this multi-menace out of here. Put her in the kennel in the yard.
Oh, come on, Nana.
I need to go and shave my trousers.
Oh, George, dear, let me help you. Good night, children. Sleep well. Oh, George, here are your cufflinks.
Hey, Tink, that man was really grumpy. He reminds me of Captain Hook.
Poor Nana. That was so unfair of Father. She worked so hard. I even heard Mother say that Nana had captured Peter Pan's shadow the other night.
So it is here, Tink.
I wish Mama would tell us another story about Peter Pan.
Is he real, Wendy? We've never seen him.
I know, but sometimes you just know something's real. Now, time to sleep.
But we want to play.
You can play all you want in your dreams. I'm rather tired too. Perhaps I have a little nap and then go and check on Nana.
Come on, Tink. We need to search quickly.
Here it is, Peter. Look, it's been ironed and hung up, although it's a bit hairy. Now let's go.
No, wait, I need to reattach it.
But despite his best efforts, the shadow would just not cooperate.
Oh my goodness, what's happening? Oh, Peter Pan, is it you? Is it really you?
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
It is you, you're really here.
Oh my goodness, you're so observant.
Cock-a-doodle-doo,
Peter Pan, at your service. Without my shadow, though, it won't go back on. I've tried everything.
Wendy, Moira, Angela, darling, at your service. So Nana really did trap your shadow.
Wendy, Moira, Angela, darling. Ha! Nobody needs names that long. I'd hate to sew the labels onto your clothes.
Hey, that's it, Peter. I can sew your shadow back on. I bet that'll work. You sit there while I get my box of tricks.
And Wendy, as always, was as good as her word.
There, all done.
Thank you, Wendy. Hey, let me give you something.
An ankle necklace. Thank you, Peter.
There, Tink, good as new.
Amazing. Can we go back to Neverland now?
Good idea. How about it? Wendy, you could come too and be our mother.
What?
Whose mother?
Mine and the Lost Boys' mother.
The Lost Boys? Who are they?
Come back with us and you'll find out.
I'm not sure I want to be anybody's mother.
You won't know until you try. Aren't you game for an adventure?
Always!
Well, come on then.
But how will we get there?
We'll fly, of course.
Oh, this is too exciting. I must wake Michael and John. Can they come too?
Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse.
Boys, wake up. Peter Pan is here and he's going to teach us to fly.
Are we in a dream, Wendy?
Not in the boat, find out. Ow, you don't need to be that enthusiastic.
Right, everyone. Think really happy thoughts and imagine yourself floating up, up, up.
Peter, it's not working.
What a shame. We'll just have to go without you. Bye.
Tink, of course. I nearly forgot. Fairy dust. Try now.
I think it's beginning to work.
Ooh. Keep thinking happy thoughts and don't look down.
Beyond your dreams. here we come.
Neverland, where minds can romp unchecked and mischievous stories roam free. If you look carefully enough, you may be able to spot some wild warriors with Tiger Lily, the chief's daughter, whose cheeks glow with the pride of her ancestors, and whose wit is so sharp you can practically see the edge of it glimmer in the moonlight.
By the spirit of Clattersnap, the great Thunderbird, let us slither through the forest and stealthily take out the pirates one by one by one by one.
One by one by one by one!
And off they slither like a giant hungry snake, silent but deadly. But in Neverland, where the page is never blank, there are always more intriguing creations around every corner or crawling out from under every rock.
Yo ho ho, yo ho ho, the pirate's life for me.
Blue rolls and limpets, those pesky wild warriors nearby. I can feel it in my hoof.
There's definitely something fishy going on here.
That's because you've got a sardine in your pocket.
Oh yeah, I bought that just in case I got a bit peckish.
Stick together, boys, Cutlass is at the ready.
Oi, Smith, mind what you're doing with that. You've always been careless with that sword, and you've just gone and done it again.
Lads, save it for those scurvy warriors. We need every man to fight them off.
Get in line, or we'll feel my hook in your gizzards.
Yo-ho, lads, and sneak up and take them by surprise.
Keep your eyes peeled, me hearties, or I'll peel them for you with this nifty peeler attachment I had made for my hook.
James Hook, Peter Pan's arch enemy. He has Peter to thank for his hook, as it was Peter who cut off his hand and fed it to a hungry crocodile who liked it so much he now stalks Hook in the hope of getting seconds and thirds and fourths. Luckily for Hook, the croc also ate an alarm clock, so whenever Hook hears it, he is warned that the croc is nearby, and that really shivers his timbers. It sounds just like... that.
Yeah.
I get scared when he's away.
Cowdy, cowdy, custard. Cowdy, cowdy, custard. Curly, cowdy, custard.
Stop it. You don't even know what custard is.
Stop arguing. Let's play. Nets, you're there.
Quick, boys, quick! There's a giant bird chasing Peter, and he wants you to kill it. It's a windy bird.
I've heard of windy birds. They're fierce.
Bows and arrows, everyone.
There it is. Let him fly, boys.
Got it!
Three cheers for Toodles. Hip, hip, hoo.
That doesn't look much like a bird.
It's got no feathers.
It looks like a lady.
And Toodles has killed it.
I bet Peter brought it here to look after us. And now...
Hey boys, good news. I've brought a mother for you.
Oops.
What is it? What's the matter?
Windy! Oh no! It was me, Peter! I killed her! It could have been any of us!
But it was actually Toodles.
That's true!
But why were you shooting at her?
Tinkle told us it was her, and that you wanted us to kill her.
Tinkerbell, Tinkerbell!
What?
You are banished forever!
No, you can't do that. I'm your fairy.
Well, for a week then.
Peter, Winnie's not dead. Just stop breathing.
Look, the acorn. Look, the arrow hit this. The acorn necklace I gave her. It saved her.
Now get to be our mother.
Oh. What's that noise?
Oh, that's just some pirates out in the lagoon.
Pirates? Yes!
Over on the Jolly Roger, James Hook is in a melancholy frame of mind, haunted, as always, by the very existence of Peter Pan.
Captain, I've just popped a batch of your favourites in the oven, crab scones with a pinch of sea salt. Oh dear, Captain, you don't look very happy. You're not thinking about Peter Pan again, are you?
Peter Pan! Peter Pan! That stupid boy with a pesky, pesky, pixie, pinchy for a freak. I, Captain Hook, am the Lord of Neverland. When I get hold of Peter Pan, I'll make him feel the steel. He'll have a closer shave than he's ever had.
Begging your pardon, Captain, but he's just a boy. In fact, that's kind of the whole point of him, so I don't think he shaves at all.
Mr. Smee, you astound me.
Oh, thank you, Captain.
I didn't think anything could be sillier than a wonky carrot, but you are. I'll pay Peter Pan back for what he did to me, cutting off my hand and feeding it to that tick-tock croc. Now that he's had a taste of me, he wants the rest of me.
You could take that as a kind of compliment, Captain.
Blazing barnacles, man! I need a plan to capture Peter Pan and his wimpy lost boys. We are pirates. Plundering, powerful...
Pongy?
Predatory pirates. They should be no match for us, those silly, simpering...
Sausages?
Simpletons. Who are we?
Is that individually, Captain, or as a group?
Mr. Smith. I didn't think you could sink any lower in my estimation. But you have. You've done it again, Mr. Smith.
I try to do my best, Captain.
We've been those pathetic lost boys, aren't we, lads?
Aye, aye, Captain.
They're nothing, nobodies.
Nah.
Non-entities.
Ooh.
Who are we?
The Pirates of the Sea.
Who are we?
The Pirates of the Sea. Pirates of the Sea!
You're a crew to be proud of.
Captain, Captain, I've just spent the last 4 hours searching the ship for the very special rum that has been invented by Captain Morgan when we last came to Jamaica. I really need it to make rumbles for dessert tonight. One of these pesky pirates has stolen it.
It's Combo! Look at him! He's as drunk as a skunk!
What should we do with the drunken sailor, Captain?
As if I don't have enough to think about.
What will we do with a drunken sailor? What will we do with a drunken sailor? What will we do with a drunken sailor at night in the morning? Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises early in the morning. Shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor, shave his belly with a rusty razor early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises early in the morning. Put him in a lumber till he's sober, put him in a lumber till he's sober, put him in a lumber till he's sober, early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning. Stick him in a scupper with a horsepipe bottom. Stick him in a scupper with a horsepipe bottom. Stick him in a scupper with a horsepipe bottom. Early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Early in the morning. That's what we do with a drunken sailor, that's what we do with a drunken sailor, that's what we do with a drunken sailor, early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning. Way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, way, hey, up she rises, early in the morning.
Wild princess.
On a mission to feed you to lift a crop, no doubt.
And, oh dear, here I am, and I seem to be totally undigested. Mission not accomplished then. But this could be a time when things happen. I have it, Smee.
Well, please don't give it to me, Captain. I have a rather delicate constitution for a pirate.
I mean, I have a plan, Smee. You and Starkey will take our little princess to Maruna's Rock in Tara. If Peter Pan hears about it, he'll try to rescue her. fancying himself the hero, but we'll be waiting to take him by surprise. And if he doesn't come, then simply enjoy watching her slowly disappear beneath the water. It's a win-win, really.
I will die with honour.
Take her away. I'll follow on. Have a splashing time. Toodaloo.
Yes, it's always a good idea to go to the loo before you take a trip, especially on water.
As chance would have it, this happens to be about the same time that Peter has decided to take Wendy and the boys to try to catch a mermaid.
Oh, I did so want to catch a mermaid.
It is really difficult, and you have to make sure that they don't try to drown you.
Look at those shimmering scales, they're so beautiful.
I've never noticed.
Why has that rock got a post in it?
It's Maruna's rock.
If you tie someone up to that post really tightly so they can't get away, no matter how hard they try,
then when the water rises higher and higher and higher and higher,
they drown.
Thank you.
goodness. The creatures who live in the depths, they're so shallow.
Suddenly, there is a cold shiver across the water, which sends the mermaids down to their coral recesses. Soon, a familiar chant is heard.
Yo-ho-ho, yo-ho-ho, it's the pirate's life for me.
The life for me! Here at last, let's get her onto the rock and then we can lie and wait for Peter Pan.
Come on, Missy, let's just tie us nice and tight so you can't swim away. Make sure to blow bubbles when the water comes over your head. The mermaids like to chase them, you know.
Those scoundrels! They've got Tiger Lily!
Be careful, Peter. They look like dangerous men.
Huh? Dangerous, eh? Well, I have an idea. Ahoy there, me hearties!
It's Captain! He must be swimming out to us!
We've tied up the princess, Captain! Nice and tight!
Untie her, you scurvies! Let her go!
But, Captain!
Blazing barnacles! You dare question me? I have my hook in you!
Best do as he says.
Not drowned already. Hope I didn't miss the fun.
We need a go, Captain.
Just like you said.
Blazing barnacles, I said no such thing.
Yes, you did, Captain.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did.
Oh, that's clever, Captain. You said that without moving your mouth.
It wasn't me, Paul.
Cock-a-doodle-doo.
Pan.
Rescue of Tiger Lily from the evil clutches of the pirates on Marooner's Rock, the wild warriors swear to protect Peter and the Lost Boys forever from the dastardly crew. As it is funny, Pete and Tinkerbell look on jealously.
Tiger Lily and the warriors swear to conduct a special ceremony for Peter and swear loyalty to him.
Let the ceremony begin.
Our brother, him we
Thank you. I thank you all.
We present our great leader with a headdress worthy of his feats.
It's made from the feathers of the southern magpie, the rarest bird on the island.
And precious stones mined from the mountain of great height.
Thank you. It was my great honour to rescue Taikalu, and I'll try to be more worthy of her respect.
I'm sure I don't know what all the fuss is about. What kind of a warrior princess needs rescuing? Anyway, I have books to read. I don't have time for all this silliness. Boys, come on, it's time for bed.
Oh, do we have to? We like it here.
Yeah, Wendy, do it for the fun.
Boys, home. You'll never grow big and strong if you don't get enough sleep.
Then just don't grow up at all.
Well, I'm going home. If you don't come now, there'll be no story.
Oh, all right.
We're coming.
If we have to.
It better be a good story.
Peter!
Not now, Tink. I'm busy. Besides, you're banished, remember? After what you did to Wendy, nearly getting her killed? Cock-a-doodle-doo!
Finally, the celebrations draw to an end and the great leader proudly takes his position back to Hangman's Tree. As is the way in Neverland, as one chapter is closing, another will be opening close by. And so we find some pirates, cutlasses drawn, once again prowling the island, looking for Peter's hideout.
Yo-ho-ho, yo-ho-ho, it's a pirate life for me.
Banished, ha, banished indeed. And all because of that prissy little madam. How could Peter take her side? It's just not fair. Acting like she's the queen of Hangman's Tree. Ha, one of these days I'll show her.
So, it's Hangman's Tree, is it? That's where his little hiding hole is. Hangman's Tree! Spice me, main grace, quickly! Let's go tell the captain to have sweet music to his ears.
Inside Hangman's Tree, the boys are waiting for the great hunter to return. And here he comes, second hand. What booty has he bagged tonight?
Oh, just for the thought he might eat me. I had other ideas, of course.
What a beauty. There must have been quite a battle. Here, take some of my very own homemade tonic to renew your strength.
Now, my master will be me. Make one up for us.
You mean mother?
Sorry!
All right. He once was a family called the Darlings.
I knew them.
I think I knew them.
And they had three children.
And a nanny called Nana, who was actually a dog.
And one night, Mr. Darling put Nana outside in a kennel in the yard. So the children flew away to Neverland, where the Lost Boys are.
Oh, Wendy, was one of them called Toodles?
Yes, he was.
Snips, am I in a story? I'm in a story.
When the parents came home from the evening out, all the beds were empty, all the children gone. Oh, imagine those poor parents. How worried they must have been. I can hardly bear to think about it.
How did we end up here, Nana?
Peter. Here's the rest of the tonic. Don't forget to take it.
Don't worry, I won't.
My tonic. Where's my tonic?
No, Peter! Don't drink it! It's red! Something's wrong!
Out of my way, Tink! You're just jealous because Wendy made it for me.
No, Peter!
Oh no, it was poison! Dear Tink, you drank it to save me. What am I going to do now? Tink! She said she could get better again if everyone believed in fairies. Do you believe in fairies? Please say you do.
Can you believe it's true? She said.
name alone strikes fear into the hearts of men, Captain Hook and his gleeful crew are in a celebratory mood. They are anticipating some planky pranks and jolly pirate japes. Mr. Smee has even baked some of his irresistible signature macaroons.
Bring out the thief!
More useful as a shelf.
A what?
A shelf! Somewhere to keep my stuff like the Baker of the Week awards that Captain gave me for my macaroons.
Mmm, very tasty! Very well deserved.
Oh, if I must, do you think that Captain will notice that I've painted in pink?
Done it again, Miss.
hour. Then we shall have some entertainment before we set off. Set them there so they can have a while to contemplate their fate. I will return shortly.
Yo ho ho, yo ho ho, you walk the plank like this. On your way down, point your toes and smile, and be sure to blow a kiss.
Stay, Michels, I never thought I'd see the day. No more pandemonium. I'll be the undisputed king of Neverland.
Captain, there seems to be some ticking around the ship. I thought you'd want to know.
The crocodile! The crocodile! How could I forget about the hungry crocodile?
How could you let me forget about the hungry crocodile? Call yourself a first mate. Just when things have been starting to look up, I find I've been surrounded by idiots all along.
What do you want us to do with the captains, Captain?
The captains! The captains! Quickly! Make them off the plane. Maybe that will satisfy the fiendish croc's hunger and give us enough time to sail away to our next adventure. It must be my nerves. My eyes are playing tricks on me. Johnny Plank looks pink.
It's just the sunset reflecting on him, sir.
Goodbye, world. Goodbye, sweet boys.
No time for all that, little missy. Hurry along.
Little missy? Don't you, little missy, me. I have learnt to fly, made up my own recipe for tonic, fought off a mermaid, and made up some of the best stories ever. I'm no little missy. I am strong. I am invincible. I am Wendy!
No splash, Captain! That's not right!
Well, you know the old saying, when the splash be not heard, you best be prepared.
What will we told? What are we, Boy Scouts? Ah, that infernal chicken! I can't concentrate!
Just take a moment, Captain. Close your eyes and listen to the sounds around you.
Listen to the sounds. Ah! I can't hear it anymore! Smee, the ticking! It stopped!
That's because the clock needs winding up, just like you.
Hey, but you're...
Dead? Then you should be even more afraid. I might be a ghost. Ooh.
Ah!
Ready, boys, have at him! Think this will be a big ship to fly.
But where are we going, Peter?
To London, of course.
darling house, Nana, despite still being a hairy thing, has been allowed back into the nursery by a Mr. Darling who feels very guilty.
If only I hadn't thrown you out there tonight, Nana. You might have stopped Peter Pan taking our children away to Neverland. If only I had known about him and his shadow. But for now, it is I who must live in the kennel as a sign of my regret.
George, there's really no need.
I can't do things by halves, Mary, you know that. So the kennel it will be until they return home.
Let's leave the window open as always and try to get some sleep.
They're in here, and they look like they've been waiting for us.
Oh my goodness! Why is Daddy in the kennel?
I think maybe we've come back just in time.
Yeah. It's been fun meeting a real fairy, Tinkerbell. Take care of Peter, won't you?
Oh, I will.
Here, have this. Thank you.
I thought I heard Wendy's voice. It must have just been a dream.
Mother, we're home!
George, Nana, they're home. They're really home. At last, our little family all back together again.
Wendy, what about the lost boys?
Oh my goodness, I'd nearly forgotten.
Lost boys? What lost boys? From Neverland, Father.
You don't mind, do you? There are only six of them.
What do you think, Nana? Let's invite them in.
And so, all in the moment, the Darling household practically doubled, and the nursery was once again filled with dragons and castles and all the wonderful stuff of imagination.
Peter, is it Peter Pan? Are you going to stay, Peter?
Would you make me go to school and then work in an office?
Yes, Peter, it's a part of growing up.
Then I'm going back to Neverland.
Will you ever go back, Wendy?
I don't know, Mother, but something of Neverland will always be with me. Who knows? Now that I've learnt to fly, I imagine I'll never forget how. Oops. Sorry, Nana.
Can I have my kennel back now?
Nana!
Oh.